Welcome back to ACM Showcase, highlighting the contenders in the top new female vocalist category. Our third and final nominee has already made a name for herself as a songwriter and is now making waves as an artist. Here's a look at Sarah Buxton. Growing up in Lawrence, Kansas, music was a fixture in Sarah Buxton's life. Choir and high school talent shows satisfied the craving for a while. But it was a meeting with Stevie Nicks that inspired Sarah to make the move to Nashville. After a stint in a southern rock band, Sarah found her voice first as a songwriter, penning the Keith Urban hit, Stupid Boy.
She never even knew she had a choice, and that's what happens when the only voice she hears is telling her she can't. Stupid Boy.
Last fall, her sense of style earned her a coveted spot in the Country Weekly fashion issue, and GAC cameras were there as a giddy Sarah shot her very first music video, Innocence.
It's great. It's a thrill, you know? It's the first time. It's like the loss of music video innocence.
Being a prolific songwriter and possessing one of the most distinctive voices in country music, Sarah is poised to quickly make a name for herself. But she's looking at it more long-term.
I think the message is to be continued. This is chapter one. Stay tuned.
It's that young girl, wide-eyed, first love, one-time innocence, yeah.
Sarah Buxton, congratulations on your ACM new female vocalist nomination.
Doggone it.
That's what it looks like, you know.
Thank you. Yeah. I know. I'm sitting there, like, looking at it going,
yeah,
is that really it? Like, can I please pick it up?
Hey, yeah, sure you can. Go ahead.
Look how beautiful it is.
Academy now. Of Country Music.
Has it sunk in yet that you're nominated with Taylor Swift and Kelly Pickler?
I can't believe I'm nominated with them. Like, I can't believe it. It hasn't really sunk in.
Do you know them at all?
I do, actually. Mm-hmm. I know Taylor better than I know Kelly, but I know both of them. Taylor, actually, I knew back when she was signed to a different label in town. She was signed to, like, RCA or something. And I wrote with her, like, a long time ago. We wrote a song called Songs About You. We were, like, writing it for Taylor, and she's just a doll. There's so much to learn, in my opinion, from new artists. And I know I'm a new artist, I know, but I'm, you know, considerably, how old is she, 17?
18.
She's 18.
Yeah.
I'm almost 10 years older than her, so.
Let's see. Kelly's 21.
Yeah, Kelly's 21. And in my opinion, there's so much for me to learn from them, because you forget the further you get into it, you know. You start to forget the magic and what's really important. And I learned so much when I hang out with her. I got to speak backstage, she was opening for Faith Hill and Tim McGraw last summer, and I got to speak with her for a little while, and she's just a breath of fresh air, Taylor. I love her.
Where did you get the news? Where were you? What comes to mind when you think back to that moment in time and all those firsts that come at this time in an artist's career?
Man, I was at my publishing company. I'd just written a song, and I was having a really good day. I forget what was going on, but I'd just written a song, and I was just getting ready to leave, and my booking agent, Rod S., had called me. He's like, Sunshine. He always calls me Sunshine. I'm like, hey. He's like, how are you doing? And I'm like, well, I'm good. How are you? And he was just like, he's like, I got some good news for you. You're nominated for top new female vocalist at the ACMs. And I was like, funny. I was like, that's a really funny joke, Rod, you know, because I thought he was kidding. You know, I don't know why, but I just thought he was joking with me. And I was like, this is not my kind of humor. You don't even know how not funny that is. And he was like, I'm not kidding. He's like, it's for real. And I just kind of was like, started to shake. I was like, you're kidding me. I was like, immediately wanted to know who else was up for it. And it's just me and Taylor and Kelly. And I was just, gee, what an honor. Couldn't believe it.
Country Weekly's fashion issue. You did your own thing there. You can tie that into what you would wear. Or what you, I mean, we're...
I like
close.
To have fun. I like to have fun with my clothes. I like to be comfortable.
Yeah, like kick off your shoes.
Like kick off my shoes and sit up in the chair like this. That's how I sit at home. So if I'm not sitting like that, I feel like I'm in a business meeting.
Well, you're not.
It's kind of weird.
Relax.
I know. Oh, it's Bill Cody. I like to have fun with my clothes, but I like to be really comfortable. And I'm definitely into taking risks. I like to wear things that I've never worn. It's kind of like dress up, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, you know, your own, like, makeup world, you know? And that's what's really fun about doing this for a living, if you want to even call it that, mm-hmm. is that you get to take risks and you get to wear flashy, cool things, you know? And I just like to take advantage of that, you know, while I have the opportunity to have people care what I'm wearing, then I might as well wear something that might make a statement of some kind, at least.
Fashion no-nos. What have you done where you've made fashion mistakes, or what do you see other people doing? You go, you want to stop them. And I could see you doing it.
Going, oh, man. Yeah, wanting
Mr. Man.
To stop? Hey, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Yeah. I get annoyed when I see somebody wearing an outfit that they're obviously uncomfortable in. To where, like, you can tell that they're kind of, like, you know, trying to stand a certain way. And it's like... I just am like, what are you doing?
Now, if I see you doing that in Las Vegas at the ACM, am I supposed to point that out?
Not in front of the cameras. Okay. Definitely. But do.
Pull you aside.
You should always...
Whisper in your ear.
Be real to me. Tell me what you think, because I always need guidance.
Sarah, you're posing.
Sarah, don't be a poser. Don't be a poser, Sarah. Just stop.